2004, I think it was, you said global warming was a total crock of shit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And my attitude has been reinforced since then.
Really? Yeah. What was it, the tornadoes today that we've never seen anything like that?
Listen, abnormal weather patterns around the world have been a fact of life. If you look at the history of hurricanes per annum. Well, when I was a kid growing up, we had hurricanes in Scarsdale, New York. That was in 1941. And none of the predictions have come true.
What about the fact that is the overwhelming consensus of all the climate scientists?
That's not true.
It is true.
No.
Yes, it is.
There is no overwhelming.
You're in the bubble, Bob. You're in the bubble.
It's all about that the president wants to make corporations the enemy. That's much easier. He's so much more comfortable fighting back against the 1%, against companies who are changing the environment, rather than against ISIS.
So
this is a more comfortable, palatable enemy
for
the White House.
Is there anything?
And ISIS, who he does not want to stand up to.
Is there anything factually incorrect about the statement that more Americans are impacted by climate change?
Mark? This is the thing. You said the timing was off. The science is off. And let me point to a very recent example. That's the most important thing. The science is off. We just had a snowstorm 2 weeks ago in New York. They told us New York City was going to get blown out. We had to give up our freedom and sit in our house. No cars on the road. Well, guess what? The models were wrong. So they got the models wrong on the science 24 hours before. How about those models 10, 20 years from now?
We do not know whether the present pause in temperature will remain for some time or whether it will go up or down at some time in the near future. What we do know with extreme certainty is that climate is always changing between pauses and that we are not capable with our limited knowledge of predicting which way it will go next. I live in Wisconsin. You know, there were 200 foot thick glaciers in Wisconsin. How do you explain man ever had a carbon footprint? How do you explain
the statement
that, carbon
that you just made is blatantly false?
How do you explain climate change that occurred 10,000 years ago before man had a carbon footprint? How do you explain
Variations in the Earth's orbital elements, the eccentricity of the Earth's orbit, the time in the season at which it's closest to the sun.
So those variations just end right now, so now it's all man-made?
One has said it is all man-made.
The tack that
however,
most take.
The man-made effect is now dominant, and we can measure that because we can measure the energy balance of the planet, and we see that there's more energy coming in is going out, so therefore the planet is going to continue to get warmer. Doesn't mean each year is going to get warmer because there are natural fluctuations, but this decade is going to be warmer than the last one, and the following morning will be
stronger. Do you dispute the satellite measurement?
Let's not talk about this satellite.
I'm asking. I understand that the global warming alarmists don't want to talk about the satellite data,
Let's talk about the satellite. Let's talk about orbital decay. Let's talk about overlapping satellite records. Let's talk about stratospheric temperature contamination. I think Dr. Christie and Dr. Spencer, when they've put this out, they have been wrong, I think, at least four consecutive times. Each time the data record has had to be adjusted upwards. There have been several sign errors. So when, with all due respect, sir, I don't know which data exactly your staff has, whether it's the first or second or third or fourth correction to Dr. Christie's data. We used to have a negative trend, then we had no trend, and now we begrudgingly have an upward trend.
Ice is also falling off the ice sheets, so that ice is up on land. So this is also going to cause the sea level to rise. So, for example, in the case of Sandy, which was not an especially big hurricane, the economic impact was $30 billion, and that's in the developed world where we have the resources to deal with it. When you have people displaced on continental scales, we're not talking about a few people trying to get through a fence at a border between countries. We're talking about tens of millions of people trying to move north, trying to move out of Southeast Asia. You're going to have trouble.
These are all predictions based on climate models.
Second, they say it's more by during that third, and they say they have a number of
Yes.
So let me ask this.
Where are we in the scale of the And I will confess, I don't understand.
20 years ago, it was out by then.
We don't like an aging company. It started in 1999.
Respect science, we can respect the planet, we can transform our energy system, and most importantly, maybe at the end of the day, we have a moral responsibility for our children and grandchildren, so that 30 years from now, they do not look us in the eye and they say, hey, all the scientists told you what was going on, why didn't you do something?